David from eSignal. Hope everyone is having a great day. Before I go further, I need to perform a sound check. In the left-hand margin, you will see a chat box window. Can a view please type yes or why if you can hear me? Okay, great. Thanks for the responses. Let's get through a few more logistics before we begin. If the audio is not clear or if you hear an echo, my suggestion is to try logging off Adobe Connect and log back on. Unfortunately, there's not much else we can do to troubleshoot any audio, video, or issues you may be experiencing. Secondly, you can find the contact information for Candle Charts and eSignal in the lower left-hand corner of the notes section. Please take some time during the webinar to jot down this information or click through if you need more information regarding Candle Charts or eSignal. However, there is also a full screen option of Adobe Connect if the images you see are smaller than you prefer. However, keep in mind that this will disable the chat function for you. As a thank you for attending, this presentation is being recorded and everyone will receive a copy sometime afterwards. At this time, I wanted to mention eSignal's special offers page. If you type in www.esignal.com/specials, you can take a look at and partake of the various special offers we have at this time. Two of the offers I wanted to highlight is you can try a 30-day risk-free trial of eSignal 12.1. eSignal 12.1 is the latest version of our flag product. Also, for those of you who are longstanding eSignal users, did you know that you can receive up to $100 in credit if you refer a friend to the program? These and other offers can be found again on our special offers page at www.esignal.com/specials. Today's webinar special offer is for those of you who purchased the Nissan candle highlighter indicator, you can get the Candlestick Quick Start Program retail value of $79 for free, again, with the purchase of the Nissan Candle Highlighter Indicator. Oops, excuse me. Do you know that eSignal offers various free online webinar tutorials each day throughout the week? Again, some of the classes we offer are for those of you who are starting up and have not tried eSignal 12.1, as well as those of you who are seasoned, experienced users of the platform. We offer basic and advanced training on eSignal 12.1. For those of you who trade in Forex or futures, we also offer webinar classes during those time. Again, those classes are free and you can sign up for as many as you want. In terms of upcoming partner webinars, on Wednesday, May 27, we're featuring David Zielinski from Shift Theory. On Wednesday, June 3rd, we're featuring Bennett McDowell from TradersCoach.com. And on Wednesday, June 10th, we'll be featuring Joe Duffy from Chady Trading Systems. These and many more presenters can be found on our eSignal Partner Webinars registration page. Lastly, for now, I wanted to provide this quick slide in terms of contact information for Candle Charts as well as eSignal sales. Again, you can go to candlecharts.com to learn more about the Candle Charts business. You can also contact Candle Charts by dialing area code 732-561-2152. You can send an email to info@candlecharts.com. And for those of you who are on social media and have a Twitter account, you could follow Steve Nison by following at Steve Nison at this point. Also, there's a there is also a product page for eSignal, the add-on product. It is www.esignal.com/Nissan special, and it'll be mentioned throughout this webinar. The price of the indicator is $49 a month. At this time, I wanted to formally introduce Steve Nison from candlecharts.com. Steve is known worldwide as the father of modern candlestick charting. He not only introduced this exciting and powerful charting method to Western traders, but he continues traders every year. His proven techniques and strategies are ideal for every type of trader. They work in every market and in every time frame. Better yet, Steve's candle charting methods allow traders to see market reversals before they become obvious to other traders. In the beginning, Steve only offered his expertise to top trading firms through his customized technical advisory and on-site seminars to institutional traders and analysts. His clients included JP Morgan, Fidelity, the Bank of New York, Goldman Sachs, Spear, Leeds and Kellogg, Morgan Stanley, hedge funds, and OTC and NYSE market makers. Currently, Steve is helping individual traders with methods that can help them win in any market conditions. That's because he has proven time and again that candle charts are the best tool to see what's going to happen in the market long before old-fashioned bar charts. In addition, Steve is an acclaimed Western technical analyst. By combining candle charts with the best Western technical indicators, he teaches his students how to get the most out of every trade and how to trade with more confidence than they ever imagined. In addition to showing you how to correctly use candlesticks, Steve will share with you today his most important trading rule, learn when to act on and when to ignore a candlestick signal, learn how to boost success by combining candlesticks with Western signals, learn how to use candlesticks to lock in profits, and more. In order to keep Steve's presentation flowing well, I ask that you please hold your questions till the end of the presentation. However, please go ahead and send in your questions through the chat box, and Steve or I will respond in due time. With these final details aside, please welcome Steve Nison from Candle Charts, this eSignal webinar. Steve, off to you.
Great, thank you. Okay, thanks so much, Ben. Am I coming in clearly? Okay, I'm assuming everybody can hear me? Great. Okay, so what we're going to do is start with a question. Okay, how many hours does it take you to find a great trade setup? Is it an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, or more than 3 hours? And you don't have to worry about typing in your answer, but I know when I would, you know, when I set up my trades, it took me many, many hours because I would set up my trades the night before because I'm running a company. And with that in mind, I was a little selfish, but I developed a program that allowed me to find great trade setups within literally minutes. And so what I decided to do is release this to the general public. And what it's called is Nison Candle Highlighter, designed for eSignal. And we're going to look at how to use NCH, Nison Candle Highlighter, in a couple of minutes to show you how you can quickly find the best candlestick signal in any market in any time frame. But I know many of you are new to candlesticks, so what I want to do is just kind of spend a couple of minutes on the value of candlesticks. They're very easy to understand. I'll go over the basic construction of the candlestick line for the small percentage of you who are new to candles. What's really powerful about candlesticks is they're first and we'll look at examples of this in some real markets to give you a reversal signal so you could jump on a new trend just as it's beginning, or equally important, knowing when to exit. Safety first, okay, knowing what trades to avoid. And as Ben mentioned in the introduction, I am an expert in Western technicals. I've been using Western technicals since 1974, believe it or not. And what I find really powerful is combining Western strategies like moving averages and trend lines and so forth to Eastern strategies, that is candlesticks. And candlesticks work in all markets as long as there's an open high, low, and close, all time frames, and it really allows you to do a very quick analysis of many markets. So with this in mind, I'm just going to go over the basic construction of the candlestick line, but let me show you why candlesticks are so powerful. Essentially, they give you twice the information as a bar chart. As we'll see in a couple of minutes, candlesticks, and I just normally call them candles, like a bar chart, will show us the price of any market. But what the candlesticks really shine at is, actually, little plain words, I didn't realize that, candlesticks shine. What they shine at is they reveal the force of the current move. And we'll look at an example of that in a minute. So let me go over the anatomy of the candlestick line. Okay, the candlestick line is made of a couple of components. There's a rectangular portion called the real body. And that is simply the relationship between the open and close. So if we have a white or empty real body, the close is higher than the open. And if we have a black real body, that means the close is under the open. And this could be in any time frame in any market. And depending on your charting package, okay, instead of a white real body, it could be a green. You know, it depends what you have your candles set on in eSignal. It could be green, and instead of black, it could be red, but the same concept. And the high is called the top of the upper shadow. It's the high of the session. And the lower the session is, the bottom of the lower shadow. So essentially, you have open, high, low, and close, which is exactly what you have in a bar chart. And that's one of the aspects about candlesticks. Whatever you do with a bar chart, whatever Western technical indicator you use with a bar chart, moving averages, trend lines, oscillators, you name it, Fibonacci retracements, you could use it with a candlestick chart. But as I showed in the prior slide, candlesticks not only show the price, but they show the force of the move. And let me show you how easy it is to understand that. So who's in control on this session here? Remember, for those who are new to candles, this is the opening and that's the closing because it's a white real body. Right, the bulls. The market opened at the bottom of the white candle and closed at the, let's get my little pointer here, and closed over here. And who is in control in the black real body? Market opened here and closed here. Right, the bears. Now, what if we get something like this, which is called the doji, where the opening and closing are the same? There's no rectangular portion. Who's in control? Is it the bulls or the bears? Right, neither. There's a balance of forces between the bulls and the bears. And why is something like this valuable? Well, let's look at this. Okay, here we have a tall green candle. The bulls are in charge. Now, notice something interesting. On the next session, aren't the closes the same, right? The close, get the arrow over here again. The close over here is the same as the close over here. But on this red arrow session, that doji session, there's an equilibrium of forces between the bulls and the bears. The Japanese would say the market is tired. And what does that mean? That means the odds of a turn are greater than they would be on that tall green candle. So in one candlestick line, we get a sense that the force of the market, in this case the bullish force, is losing momentum. So for example, the highs here in Google a couple of months ago, a doji. And a lot of things you could do with doji. Obviously, this is not a course in candlesticks. You could set up the doji as a potential resistance area, and if the market closes above it, it's actually a bullish breakout. But a very basic thing you could do with doji is use it as resistance. And obviously, not ever after every doji, the market's going to sell off. But you could see that with the doji and the market kind of topping out right around the same area, it increases the likelihood of the market reversing. So candles, as shown in the title here, reveal the force of the move. And as I mentioned when we described the construction of the candlestick line, you could use all your favorite Western indicators with candlesticks. And by the way, I call these Nissen candlesticks because you know you're getting the right candlestick information. There's a lot of really bad and dangerous candlestick information out there. There are other educators out there that are, I don't know where they get their knowledge from, but I had dozens of books translated from Japanese to English. I spent tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars and 30 years, since mid-1980s. Yeah, 30 years real-world experience using candles. So that's why we call them Nissen candlesticks. Candlestick education, candlestick indicators the correct way. So you could easily add your favorite Western indicators. For example, here, this was back at the highs of Apple a while ago. We had a series of small real bodies in the circled area, these doji. And by the way, the plural of doji are doji. And it was at the top of a Bollinger band. And I like using Bollinger bands to gauge overbought, oversold. So this is what we mean by the multiplier, what I call the multiplier effect. If you get a candlestick signal confirming one of your favorite Western indicators, I'd be more aggressive on a trade. Or in this case, if I was long, I certainly would consider taking profits. But as valuable as candlesticks are in confirming Western indicators, one of the great benefits you're going to find within Nissen Candle Highlighter that's going to highlight my favorite candlestick signals, and I'll describe NCH in a couple of minutes, is the candles allow you to get reversal signals before traditional Western indicators. Let me show you a case here. So over here, okay, scenario one, you buy at the candlestick signal. This is a bullish candlestick signal called a hammer. And it's a nice signal, of course, it's confirming a support area. So let's say you buy there with the market at 395 and you could exit, there's a doji over here. Doji are great for taking potential profits. So you get exit the Doji at 447. So this gives you a potential profit of $52 a share. Now, let's say you use the MACD, which is this. It's a popular Western indicator. And I'm not going to go through exactly what the MACD is. I'm sure many of you are familiar with it. But essentially, it tells you when the trend is changing. And for the MACD trend to go from down to up, you know you have to have the blue line crossing above this yellow line here. You have the crossover. So you would have gotten the buy signal with the MACD over here. You know, still a nice trade. You buy in the MACD at 418. You could still use the Doji to exit at 447. A nice profit, $29 a share. But this is what the candlesticks are all about. Thanks to the candles, you generated an extra potential $23 a share. So if you purchased 100 shares, you're looking at an extra $2,300. And this is perfectly, you can use candles, it's perfectly applicable. Not many of us trade Google or Apple outright. We'll use options. So candles are great for options also. So let's now look that we've done a very brief overview of how to use candlesticks. As Ben mentioned, I'll tell you how you can get a free resource, a streaming video that gives you more details about the essentials of candles. But what I want to do now is start to give you the basics of our Nissan Candle Highlight. Nissan Candle Highlighter. It's a brand new app we designed for the eSignal platform. And the most valuable aspect about it is that you know when you have a candlestick signal highlighted with NCH, Nissan Candle Highlighter, it's going to be a valid candlestick signal. And as Scott mentioned, everyone that teaches candles quotes the master, why not go to the master? And many of us have this problem, and I'm going to show you how NCH helps you overcome these issues. How many of us have made a trade or investment we wish we didn't make? Well, NCS is going to help you avoid this by avoiding placing wrong trades on the candlestick signals, on wrong candlestick signals. Because at the end of the day, it's not only how much money you made, but how much you made plus how much you didn't lose. And another issue that NCS will help you overcome is it lets you jump on golden trading opportunities. We've all felt like this before, right? And so let's look at how this works. So we're going to now look at one of the basic patterns very briefly. We'll look at a bullish engulfing pattern. That's when a white real body wraps around a black real body. Again, I could spend a good half an hour on engulfing patterns, but I just want to give you the basic definition. We can see the bulls are taking over from the bears. A bearish engulfing pattern is when a black or, you know, it could be a red real body wraps around a green, a white or a green real body, depending on how you have your candlestick signals, your bull and bear signals set in the up and down days with the candles set in E-signal. So let's look at this. So here, you could see we have a little plus E. This is, you could pull up, the way NCH works is you could pull up any chart in any time frame, and you could have any and all of my favorite candlestick signals. So here, we have the bullish engulfing pattern highlighted. So all bullish engulfing patterns are going to show up within the Nissan candle highlighter. So here we have a bullish engulfing pattern, potential bottom reversal signal. And normally, most of these candlestick signals you could use to set protective stops. So normally I'd have, do my arrow here. Normally I'd have a stop. There we go. Normally I have a stop under the low of the bullish engulfing pattern. But since the low here, this happens to be a hammer, but I didn't have a hammer highlighted on NCH. Since the low here is so close to the low here, here's where I'd have my protective stop. So that's a bullish engulfing pattern. Here's a couple of bearish engulfing patterns. Confirming a resistance area, great time to take profits. Now let me show you what NCH can mean to your portfolio. Now notice over here, well, let me go back here. You notice over here we have a bullish engulfing pattern. Let me show you something interesting. Notice how, and I'll put a little box here, there's a green candle wrapping around a black real body. Now, why did that not show up as a bullish engulfing pattern in NCH? Because it really was not a bullish engulfing pattern. A bullish engulfing pattern has to come after essentially a downtrend. And we have proprietary indicators on how we define trend. So notice that that was not a bullish engulfing pattern, while at the green, at the blue arrow that just emerged, it is a bullish engulfing pattern. So what that means is you would have avoided buying on this, what some may have viewed as a bullish engulfing pattern, and you could have bought on the true bullish engulfing pattern as signaled by NCH. So in other words, you potentially buy money not lost and potential money gained, you're looking at, you know, about $70 per share. And once again, as I mentioned, here happens to be Google. Think about what it can mean to your option trading. Okay, here we have a classic hammer. Just some examples of what NCH does. So you can pull up all my 28 candlestick signals or just some of them. So here, if you have a group of candlestick signals, confirming a support area, what a great trading opportunity this happens to be. Here we have a bullish engulfing pattern. Over here, this is a piercing pattern. And you'll have a sheet that shows you all what all the symbols are. I'll tell you how you will get that. Here we have a bullish engulfing pattern, a hammer, another little hammer, a bullish engulfing pattern. Boy, you know, how many signals do you want at major support? And this is what unfolded after. Now, just a little bit of an alert. NCS does not generate buy sell signals. It gives you potential high probability trade setups. So what will happen is you'll pull up a chart. And let me actually look at this one. You'll pull up a chart and you'll say, hey, you have a hammer over here. NCH picks up a hammer. You can think about if you want to buy on that hammer, or as I mentioned before, many of these candlestick signals, just about all of them, could be used as support or resistance. If for some reason you don't want to buy on that hammer, you don't think it's a good risk reward, and I'll talk about risk reward in my next slide, you may want to wait for a retracement to the low of the hammer. So what you could do is when you have the hammer, and if you don't want to buy when the market near the close, because the candlestick signal is not confirmed until the market closes, you could set up an alert, an eSignal, to be alerted when the market gets near the low of the hammer. You can be alerted, and then you can think about buying and have a protective stop under the low of the hammer. Now, let me tell you about my, let me show you this, because this is one of my most important trading rules. As promised, I want to discuss this briefly in this webcast and recording. Now, let's look at these two signals picked up by Nissan candle highlight. We have a bearish engulfing pattern and a shooting star. Shooting star is a candlestick with a long upper shadow and small real body, black real body or a doji. Now, normally one would say, hey, this is really more bearish, the bearish engulfing pattern. Look at this. This black real or this red real body envelops. Look at the size of that black real body compared to the green real body. Now, that could be really, really bearish. I'm going to be selling on this or shorting on this or, you know, at least exiting my long position. And look at the shooting star. We would think that is not as bearish. Now, keep in mind, candles don't give price targets. What we need to do is when we're setting up a trade with the NCH candlestick signals, we have to think about what our target is and what's our stop out level. So here, if we sold it here, we'd have a protective stop up here. And the target, at least my target, would be the recent low. So think about this. This would be your target. This would be your risk. That is a bad risk reward. Whereas this shooting star gives a great risk reward, because if you sell it here and your stop is above the high here and the target is the most recent low, which is over here, that is a great risk reward trade. So one of my most important rules as far as trade management is concerned, always think about the risk reward of any trade. Okay, we looked at this before. And piercing pattern as a support area. And what's nice about that, it lets you define your risk because you could set a protective stop under the low of the piercing pattern. And one of the things you, what I personally do, and what I recommend you think about doing it, is, yes, once you get a candlestick signal on the on your chart with Nison candle highlighter, see if it confirms a Western signal. One of my favorite Western indicators, very basic, just horizontal support and resistance. So here we have a resistance area, and the shooting star stalled right near the resistance area. So in this case, if I sold it on the shooting star, I'd have a protective stop not here, I'd have a protective stop over here. So I love it when candlestick signals confirm horizontal support or resistance. Now here's a nice example, just a couple, you know, the past couple of months in steel. So H is a hammer. We had a hammer on the lower left. If you buy it there, keep a protective stop under the low of the hammer. You could exit on the dark cloud cover. And a dark cloud cover is when a red real body gets more than halfway into a green real body. And I'll tell you how you can get all these signals. Well, you know what a dark cloud cover is and what a hammer is in a couple of minutes, for those who don't know. So if you did this particular trade, you're looking at a potential 20% profit. Now, not many of us short, but if you did decide to short or you do a bearish option trade on the dark cloud cover, okay, you could have shorted on the dark cloud cover, have a protective stop above the high of the dark cloud cover, and notice how we got another hammer, classic hammer, picked up by NCH, and you could have covered there. And for those of us who mainly go long, let's say you didn't go short on that dark cloud cover, let's say you didn't short here, you're looking to buying opportunities, this actually is a great hammer to buy. Why is this such a good hammer to buy on? What is it confirming? See the low over here? It's confirming a support area. So if you bought in that hammer and you rode it to the dark cloud cover, remember candlestick signals in NCH are great for taking profits. You could have potentially made a 10% profit on that particular market. So this is kind of a brief overview of the NCH and your resources for NCH. Let me tell you what kind of what your resources will be. It's really easy to use. Is you'll have access to this resource page, and there's no software to deliver. You just go to this link, download it, and then we have a couple of short videos, maybe 8-minute videos on how to install NCH and how to use NCH within eSignal. We have an FAQ section within the resource page, and we also have really great technical support for any questions on NCH. Obviously, any eSignal questions, we do recommend that you go to the experts at eSignal. Now, as a bonus, you will have the reference guide, a highlight key. So, for example, when you see a plus H on Nissan candle highlighter, you'll know it's a hammer, and this is what it looks like, the hammer. When you have a, for example, a minus H here, this will be a shooting star, and these are examples of what the shooting star looks like. So really, really very easy to use. You have actually 28 signals all together. If I added them correctly, we have some, these are the bearish signal, bullish signals. These are the bearish signals, and we actually have a couple of neutral signals. The doji, a lot of people misuse doji. People see a doji and they get all excited and they think about selling automatically. In fact, years ago, before I made these strategies available to the general public, I only used to do seminars for institutional clients, as Ben mentioned, Goldman Sachs. I even spoke at the Federal Reserve and World Bank and so forth. And one of the head traders at one of the, when they used to do proprietary trading, which they don't do anymore, one of the head traders said, he sent me an email. He said, Steve, you're right about a little knowledge being a dangerous thing. All my traders are running around here shouting doji, 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 because doji is so easy to pick up. And doji really is a neutral signal. So when you have a rally and the market has a doji, it doesn't turn the trend from up to down. It turns it to neutral. And what that means is it just increases the likelihood of the market reversing. It doesn't mean it's going to definitely reverse. Likewise, with a high wave candle, okay, high wave candle, just the candle with a very long upper lower shadow, it shows the market's confused. very similar to being like a doji. It's a neutral candlestick signal, but the more obvious ones like the bearish, the bullish engulfing pattern, where a white candle, you know, wraps around a black real body, like over here, we could see the bulls are taking over from the bears, so that's potentially more bullish than a doji. And a bearish engulfing pattern where the black real body wraps around the white real body, we could see that's more likely bearish because the bears are taking control. So remember, NCH does the work for you. It's really as easy as 1, 2, 3. So let's look at this particular market. Actually, it should be NCH. Nissan Candle Highlight finds a bullish engulfing pattern at 1. Okay, you see that, and I'll get my little thing here. Okay, a bullish engulfing pattern plus E. And what I would do is see if it's confirming a Western indicator. So step 2, you see it's at a support area. To me, that's a really good buying opportunity, assuming it's a good risk-reward. Remember the concept of risk-reward. And step 3, you exit at the bearish engulfing pattern all the way up here. Or you can even exit at the doji. And, you know, maybe you want to take some profits at the doji over here. Now, the reason the doji is not highlighted in NCH, because I really want to focus on the engulfing patterns. But normally, when you have NCH running, you will see this as a doji. But here we have a bearish engulfing pattern. And even if you took some profits here, nothing wrong with that. But I like this because remember what I said before about the doji? It's not a bearish reversal signal. It's telling you the trend's going from up to down. And this doji, I would only use to take some profits on long, as I would not sell short on this doji, because notice how the doji here is a higher close than the close over here. So something like that, I like to get some bearish confirmation. And notice these two doji, the plural of doji, by the way, are doji, are still holding the high closes very well. So this bearish engulfing pattern actually is the bearish confirmation of a topping signal, of a top. So this is where I'd be exiting. So, you know, nice little profit by using NCH, looking at a potential 23% profit. So as Dwayne mentioned, NCH saves hours of time. It makes reacting to the developing patterns much faster. All you do is you pull up any chart, and all my favorite candlestick signals are going to appear on them. It's a great educational tool and also inspires trading confidence by having the capability of Steve's insights right on the chart you're studying. In fact, one of the NCH users said it's like me sitting at the trading desk next to them. So I hope you agree with me. This really sounds great. And then the obvious question is, how do I get NCH? Well, the easiest way is, as Ben mentioned in the introduction, and he has it posted in the chat window, is you go to this link. It's only $49 a month for the Nissan Candle Highlighter. And another way you can get it is you could also do it within the eSignal platform. And there's a drop-down menu. I'm sure many of you are familiar with this. You just go to eSignal apps. I'm using 12.1, so I'm assuming prior versions have this also. And you can go to the eSignal app store and just find the app in there. Now, as I mentioned before, as a special bonus for those of you who are new to candlesticks or want a refresher course, what we designed was what we call the Quick Start Guide video. It's a streaming video to get you quickly up to speed on candlesticks. And what that is what's, these are some of the topics that are covered in the Quick Start video, my 7 power concepts, learning about the psychology of markets. I have a secret hammer strategy, the multiplier effect, which I just touched on over here, how to use shadows correctly, and a lot of other really cool features. And if you go to my website, you don't have to, but take my word for it. If you go to my website at candlecharts.com, you will see we are offering the Quick Start Guide, and this is the general public price at $79. And what we're doing as a special thank you for eSignal for allowing me to work with them is we're giving this to you at no cost when you order the NCS app. So essentially, you're getting a $79 bonus for a app that you're only paying $49 a month for. So with that, I'll put on the slide again, give you the link, and I'll turn it over to Ben, and I'll stay around a couple of minutes for any questions. Again, any eSignal questions, I defer to the expert. So over to you, Ben. And thanks for the opportunity to allow me to speak to such a great group.
Thanks, Steve. So folks on the line, can you kindly send in your questions to the chat box window and I'll glance through and either Steve or I will respond. So the question was, does NCH have a scanning function? Are you familiar with this question, Steve? Is this something you can
answer?
Yes,
no, it doesn't have a scanning, function.
Okay. So I think that answers Richard, Bruce's, and Dennis's question. Okay. There's a couple more people typing in. So again, folks, you know, please type in your questions. Steve or I will respond in due time. So Rich, Michael's question is, does it
what he means by that.
Michael, can you elaborate a little bit more on that question? Okay. So Chris, for today, Steve is just focusing on the presentation. We won't be able to do a demo of the NCH product at this time. So William asked, this is a question for you, Steve, since he doesn't have eSignal, but he wants to know how he could, I assume it's available through your website?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Nicholas' question. So Steve, do you use any other types of strong confluence that help you aside from regular support and resistance?
That's a good question, because one of the things that you could do that I do within the eSignal is I'll set up a template. So I'll have a Western template, and I have some of my favorite Western indicators on the template. So for example, I like using Bollinger Bands. I like looking at 20 and 50 day moving averages. I like to keep it real simple. And then when I have that template, what I'll do is I'll pull up a chart on that template, and then I'll pull up my Nissan candle highlighter and see what candlestick signals are on that particular, let's say I'm looking at a Google. So I have my template, I have Google open, I have my Bollinger Bands on there, I have my moving averages on there, and then I highlight, then I put in my NCH, the candlestick signals are highlighted on that chart, and I'll see if any key candlestick signals like a hammer or engulfing pattern on the bullish side, or you know, shooting star or bearish engulfing pattern on the bearish side, confirm my Western indicators. So I like to keep it real simple. I like Bollinger Bands, horizontal trend lines, horizontal support and resistance, and a couple of moving averages to get the longer-term trend. If the 20-day and the 50-day are, if the 20 is above the 50 and they're both sloping up, I view the intermediate-term trend as up, and I then look for bullish trades on pullbacks, whereas if the 20-day is under the 50-day moving average, what the Japanese call the dead cross, I'll look for bearish trades to sell on rallies.
Okay. So, Steve, back to Michael's original question. I think he kind of elaborated a little bit more. So, Michael Richards' question is, in eSignal, you can add indicators to a watch list on specified timeframes. If this, meaning the NCA, highlight discovered entries.
Oh, sorry. you know, if he could maybe send, if he could email us at the, I think you have the link there, info@candlestickcharts.com, and our eSignal/NCH guru will get back on that, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, and Michael, again, I provided the link to our About Us section. Feel free to contact or shoot a chat box or an email to our tech support. That's something that they could definitely look into for you. Okay, so going through the other questions, there's a lot of them coming in. Thank you guys, folks, for making this a very interactive conversation right now. So again, a lot of questions regarding, can they get the Candle Quick Start program without eSignal? Again, yes, you'll need to go to candlecharts.com. But again, I'll purchase the Nissan Candle for those of you who are on the eSignal platform. It comes for free for you. So that's great.
Yeah, and that's interesting. I mean, even if they want to use it for a month for $49, they're getting a $79 item.
Correct. Correct.
Yeah.
Let's see. So Graham Matthews, thank you, Graham. I'm glad you liked the topic and Steve's material today. Steve, so his question is, which mentor a beginner?
Books. Probably Japanese candlestick charting techniques. But I would strongly suggest for a beginner, go to our website or you can contact info. We have streaming videos that are perfect for beginners. A quick start video, streaming video is great for a beginner. But we have like a full-day seminar. We have a four-volume set, and volume one would be good. So I think the best answer to that question is contact info@candlecharts.com, and they'll get back to you with the appropriate educational vehicle, depending on your trading style.
Okay, thanks. So next question is coming from David Smith, and his question is, will this work with Excel? And David, just can you please clarify, are you referring to the candle highlighter, or are you referring to the quick start program? So I'm not sure specifically which one you're referring to, but if it's the candle highlighter, no, it will not work in Excel. You'll need to have eSignal 12.1 to leverage the indicator. Steve's question is, the next question from Steve is, how many patterns can be programmed to be highlighted at the same time?
Within, 28.
I assume 28, okay.
28, yeah. And what I did was, once you start the highlighter, you have all 28 signals highlighted, and you could check and uncheck them.
Okay. So the next question from Nicholas is, Steve, at what time frame do you feel the accuracy and validity of these NCH begins to drop in signal strength? In other words, should he stick to 4 hours and above?
It's all going to be trial and error. It depends on your market. The Japanese have a wonderful phrase. They say the market is like a person's face, never two alike. And same thing, you could look at different markets, different time frames. I would just experiment with it. And, I would experiment with it.
Okay. One question came in from, I believe the name is Badresh. And Badresh, I'm gonna state your question, but I'm gonna ask you to rephrase it a little bit more. So when you say which platform is your program most suited for, are you referring to the Quick Start program, or are you referring to the Nison candle highlighter? And right now, I believe, Steve, the candle highlighter is strictly on eSignal. So I'm obviously going to promote the eSignal brand, but
right.
To clarify, if you're referring to the Quick Start program, I don't believe that's on any specific program. Is that right?
Right. It's the Quick Start is an educational video. Is there a way I could screen share? We should.
Sure.
Yeah, this way. How do I do that?
Well,
what I'm going to do is,
if you stop sharing your documents, Steve,
I can show them the height, what it looks like, real time. I could show them what it looks like.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, folks, for those of you who didn't hear, Steve's going to be loading up his Quick Start program, so you can take a look and see what it's involved.
Well, not the Quick Start, the candle highlighter, so I could show
what it looks like. Oh,
yeah.
Okay, great. Steve's
okay, yeah, I just
load
forgot
up,
to, you know, it's so funny. I forgot to, include a slide of actually what it looks like within eSignal. So,
okay.
So what do I?
So Ken, while he's loading it up, Ken, I know you had a question regarding how much is eSignal per month. I'm going to send you to our product page, where you could take a look and see and learn more about pricing information regarding the product.
Okay.
Starts from roughly $45 a month if you sign up for on demand, up to $295 if you get the whole bells and whistles, including our advanced get products. So I'm going to send you that link so you could kind of compare and contrast what makes sense for you.
Okay. So what I do, Ben, share my screen. How do I get, what do I do?
So if you filter underneath it, there's going to be an option to either share my screen or share document.
Right.
If you hit the share my screen, it'll load up whichever screen you have eSignal on. There you go.
Oh, there we go. Okay. So let me, I have a really big screen. I don't know if it matters or not. So, okay, hold on. Okay, let's see if this works. Okay. Whoops. Can you see it?
We can see it.
Great. Okay, so let me show you what it looks like. All right, so here's the Nissan candle highlighter. And notice you could uncheck any of these. So I'm just going to randomly check. And by the way, for those who trade intraday, I would normally have Doji and High Wave Candle turned off. Because you get so many highway candles and doji, but I'm not going to check them all off. But you can see, as you check off the patterns, you'll get more and more. And you'll have that resource that'll show you what an SH is or this is. So here's like a falling window over here. Okay. And a lot of times a falling window becomes potential resistance area. Here we have another falling window. Here we have a bullish engulfing pattern. So this is what the NCH looks like within. E-signal, yeah. So you can have all 28. You could pick and choose which candlestick signals you want to have highlighted. So it's as simple as that. Okay, so I'll go back to the non-sharing. So how do I go back to the screen again?
You could just hit stop sharing. I'm going to hit a request control. You're going to see a button right now. Okay, and at that point, you know, we can go back to the original page you had at that point.
There we go.
Yeah. So, Michael, just to answer your question, why not add these abbreviations into the eSignal study panel? There's a lot of variations along the line, you know, and obviously those are conversations we have with partners such as panel chart. So at the time, I think it was just chosen not to load it up within the study panel. But food for thought. Can we get it into the eSignal study panel? So, okay. Rodney Cubbage, so your question was, too many patterns is confusing. Which four would you recommend starting with?
I would, from the bullish side and the reverse on the bearish side, I would do the hammer, the bullish engulfing pattern, the piercing pattern, and probably a morning star, and the flip side, so it would be a shooting star, a dark cloud cover, a bearish engulfing pattern, and an evening star. And keep in mind, I mean, normally, let's say we have a relatively weak signal, let's say a doji, which is normally not a strong reversal signal, but if that's confirming a resistance area, I would view that doji as more negative than I would a dark cloud cover not confirming resistance. So what I would do is look for, again, personally, is what I do, look for horizontal support and resistance, and then see if any candlestick signals confirm those. You may like Fibonacci retracements or any of your favorite Western indicators. Have that on a template, and then see if a candlestick signal confirms it. But those would be probably the major ones I would do, the four major bullish and bearish ones. And also windows, rising and falling windows.
Another question came in from Bob Sammy. So the question is, Steve, does NCH indicate entry or exit strategy?
Potentially. It doesn't give you buy and sells, but that's the whole premise with NCH. It gives you potential trade setups. So the whole drive of this webcast and video, for those who are watching the recording, is you're going to get a candlestick signal. What do you do with it? If it's confirming a Western indicator, if you have a good risk reward, then you could think about setting up a trade. So it gives you the what the Japanese do, and what I found works really well, is use the candlesticks as the final confirmation before pulling the trigger. You could have a market at support, and to me, I would be much more aggressive buying on a support level if we get a candlestick signal than I would if we didn't.
Okay. Great comments. Great questions, everyone. Appreciate the interactive questions were coming in from Steve. Nicholas has a long one, so let me kind of read it right now. So does the indicator have an option to send an audio alert explaining the time frame as well as signal type found? In other words, as opposed to only showing the signals up from the chart you are currently viewing.
As far as I know, it just shows the signals on the chart you're currently viewing.
Okay. But that's a good, you know, that's good feedback, Nicholas. You know, obviously, if that's additional, you know, questions or requests from others, then that's something that obviously Steve and team will take into consideration.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that's great. Just send us some ideas and, you know, I could see if our programmer could work with the eSignal programmers and add that as a feature. Sure.
Mm-hmm. All right. Folks, our webinar is kind of running long right now. I want to make sure that we leverage Steve's time appropriately. Can we get in any final questions before we close out the webinar? Oh, so Michael, get that developer onto the job, Steve. I'll defer to Steve on that regard. So, any other questions, folks, before we close out the webinar? Okay. Wow, now we got a bunch of people. I'm getting a lot of people tapping in right now, Steve, so bear with them.
Okay.
No, thank you, audience, for attending today's event. So, we want to make sure we leverage Steve's time accordingly.
I can stay around for another couple of minutes, so I'll wait.
Yeah. Okay, I think everyone's just now applauding you, Steve, and I guess we can formally close out this webinar. Okay. So again, folks, in the notes section, we have the contact information for Candle Charts. You could either go to the website, call them directly, follow Steve on Twitter, or go to the product page, which is highlighted in the main page here, to partake of this special. Again, by purchasing the subscribing to the Nison Candle Highlighter Indicator, you get the Nison Quick Start Program valued at $79 for free as part of purchasing it. At this time, I wanted to thank Steve for taking time out of his schedule to spend time with us today. I would also like to thank all of you for coming to today's webinar and hope that you found it useful for your trading education. As a final reminder, you will be receiving a recorded copy of today's webinar as a thank you for attending. We hope you have enjoyed this webinar and will join us again soon. Thank you and have a good rest of your day.
Great. Thank you, Ben, and thank you, everybody.
Thank you.